Gar. Greetings, I am Tad Larkin, the lore master of Manda-LORE. And today, I'll be digging through the archives to elaborate on the Fell Empire. Established sometime after 44 ABY and forged from the ashes of the Imperial Remnant, the Fell Empire is a fully reorganized galactic nation, centered around a singular monarch descending from a line stretching all the way back to Jagged Fell and Jaina Solo Fell. Though the Emperor or Empress was the de facto head of state, his or her power was equivalent to the power held by some of the earlier Supreme Chancellors of the Galactic Republic, except this title was hereditary rather than an elected position. The true executive and legislative power within the Fell Empire lay with the Council of Moths, led by a High Moth, while Chief of State of the Military was held by a Grand Admiral, a tradition going all the way back to Grand Admiral Palian. The seat of Imperial power was the Outer Rim world of Bastion, though Coruscant would be briefly recaptured in later years. Sworn in absolute loyalty and fealty to the Emperor, the Imperial Knights were a sect of the Jedi Order, only, rather than serving the Force, they served the Empire and the Imperial mission, also acting as bodyguards for the Emperor, as well as a safeguard should the Emperor ever turn to the dark side. The Imperial mission is the closest thing to a religion within the Fell Empire, practicing the Emperor's victory without war initiative by establishing missions on many worlds and through missionaries spreading the ideals and principles of the Fell Empire throughout the neighboring system. The Imperial military was largely structured the same as it had been during the Old Galactic Empire under Palpatine's reign, with the exception of the inclusion of females and non-humans within positions not traditionally held by females or non-humans. It was not uncommon to see Kalish or even Tauss stormtroopers, with armor specially tailored to fit the more robust of the non-human species, and stormtrooper armor itself, while almost unchanged aesthetically, was enhanced with new sensory equipment and life protection technologies. Other elements of the Imperial military, such as the mechanized divisions, were also more high-tech variations of older Imperial vehicles, with more advanced armor and weapon systems for the modern age. The Imperial Navy, however, underwent ostentatious reforms following the century after the fragmenting of the old Galactic Empire, and the new Palian-class Star Destroyers took the role of the old Imperial 1 and 2 class Star Destroyers long since retired. With the establishment of the Fell Empire by Jagged Fell, sometime after 44 ABY, the Fell Empire slowly but surely began to gain territories as more and more systems seceded from the Galactic Alliance in the wake of the Imperial missions being established on their worlds. The medical professionals, engineers, teachers, and scientists stationed at these missions brought aid to those impoverished worlds that were devastated in the wake of the Yuuzhan Vong and the Second Galactic Civil War, increasing their prosperity and happiness, all while preaching the values and virtues of the Fell Empire. By 127 ABY, with more systems slipping from its fold and joining the Fell Empire, the Galactic Federation of Free Alliances, or Galactic Alliance as it's more colloquially known, tried its own methods of healing the wounds of the Yuuzhan Vong by employing Yuuzhan Vong shapers themselves. Tasked with terraforming these beleaguered worlds, the Jedi Order under Grandmaster Cole Skywalker greatly endorsed these methods used by the shapers after witnessing the once barren Jedi Library world of Ossus restored to its former glory, not seen since the days of Ulla Keldroma and the Great Sith War. A revitalized Sith Order led by Darth Krayt, a former Jedi from the Old Republic, Asharad Het, who had since extended his life with Yuuzhan Vong implants, sabotaged the attempted world seeding, causing the ecosystems of these affected worlds to worsen rather than improve. In the panic, thousands of these worlds left the Galactic Alliance, seeking help from the Fell Empire and joining its fold, causing even further tensions between these two nations. War broke out shortly after, as High Moff Morlish Veed and Moff Nina Calixte, who were under the influence of Darth Krayt, went against Emperor Rhone Fell's wishes and enacted the Treaty of Anaxes, inciting the war. It was later in the war that Krayt and the Sith revealed themselves as allies of the Empire, much to the dissatisfaction of Roan Fell and the Imperial Knights, refusing to endorse them throughout the entire conflict. The conflict lasted 4 years before the Galactic Alliance was finally broken at the Battle of Ka'amas in 130 ABY, where the Galactic Alliance fleet was surrendered. Krayt, meanwhile, took this opportunity to order an attack under Fell's nose on the Jedi Academy on Ossus, the Jedi Order's last stronghold following the fall of the new Jedi Temple on Coruscant, and there, most were massacred, save a few Jedi and a bunch of Padawans who escaped. Coruscant was soon recaptured, and Roan Fell moved his throne from Bastion to Coruscant, but not before Krayt enacted the next phase of his plan, killing Fell and proclaiming himself Emperor, making the Moff swear fealty to him. The real Roan Fell was well aware of Krayt's treachery, and escaped, consolidating his loyalist forces and launching guerrilla strikes on Krayt's empire for the next 7 years before retaking Bastion in 137 ABY. Meanwhile, Princess Marisaya Fell acted as a liaison between her father Roan and potential loyalists stuck behind enemy lines still within Krayt's empire. Eventually, plans to link up with the Galactic Alliance remnant led by Admiral Stasi came to fruition despite many setbacks and apparent Sith sabotage, leading to an uneasy alliance between them. Both forces capitulated for the first time against Krayt's empire at the Battle of Raltir, and with their cooperation pulled a monumentous victory which led to the destruction of the dreaded Coruscant Third Fleet. After the Battle of Raltir, an attempt was made by the Moffs of Krayt's empire to abduct and bring Roan Fell to trial for treason, and above Agamar, they chose to ambush a meeting between Fell and the surviving members of the Jedi Council. Fell was able to escape, and although the Jedi agreed to work with Fell in their common goal of eliminating Krayt's empire, Princess Marisaya was captured, and a number of valuable ships and a competent admiral was lost. In 138 ABY, Fell Imperial forces aided the Jedi in defending their hidden temple on the Outer Rim world of Tavis, and although the temple was lost, a majority of the Jedi were evacuated with the assistance from the Imperial Knights, as well as the Imperial Navy. Secretly dealing with a Sith dissident, Darth Malati, Roan Fell came into the possession of enough Alpha Red, a biotoxin, to wipe out all life on Sith-occupied Coruscant, and convinced both the Galactic Alliance and the regrouped Jedi Order to conduct an all-out daring assault on Coruscant, and so they did. A mixed strike team of Jedi as well as Imperial Knights infiltrated behind enemy lines and brought down the planetary defenses, allowing for more ground forces to land as well as engaging Darth Krayt himself. As Darth Krayt was struck down at the hands of Cade Skywalker, Roan Fell, meanwhile, was aboard his flagship, just waiting for the right moment to launch the Alpha Red, unaware that it would actually kill everyone on Coruscant except the Sith, contrary to Darth Malati. Roan's own impatience and anger began to consume him, and the debate over the Alpha Red with his daughter and most trusted Imperial Knights turned into a brawl as he slipped further towards the dark side. But before the Alpha Red could be unleashed, Antares Draco, remembering his duty as an Imperial Knight, slew the Emperor through the back with his own blade, saving countless lives in the process. With Krayt dead, his galactic empire began to crumble, and Darth Nihil, who took Krayt's place, ordered all surviving Sith to withdraw and fight another day. The funeral for Roan Fell proceeded soon after, and subsequently, Empress Marisaya Fell ascended to the throne. By the Second Imperial Civil War's conclusion, the Galactic Federation Triumvirate was created soon after, uniting the forces of the Fell Empire, Galactic Alliance, and the Jedi Order into one cohesive coalition for the betterment of the galaxy. This transmission was suggested by Casey Smullen. If you have any suggestions for future transmissions, don't be afraid to drop a comment. In the meantime, keep your comm channels open for future transmissions, and don't forget to subscribe! Tad Larkin. out.